Let me ask you a question. Do you like hard rock? Do you like obscure old school hard rock? I believe these guys are going to be that. Today we're going to be doing White Spirit. This is a band that I have never heard of before. They popped up on my radar. I said, I'm doing this. So today we're going to do the song Midnight Chaser. And it looks like it's from this album that we're doing here, Midnight Chaser. And it's got 23,000 plays on it. And I don't know anything about this band, but it intrigued me enough that we're going to get into them. Sound good? Let's learn about them. White Spirit have 1,574 monthly listeners to the Spotify account. The top five jams, the one we are doing today, has 23,148 plays. That's the number one. From this same album, there's Red Skies. That's got 9,829 plays. Then you've got a song called Cheetah. That's got 11,000 plays. Then back to this album we're doing here, Way of the Kings. 4,700 plays, and again from that album, High Upon High, 4.9. Are these guys going to be Christian? I'm starting to wonder. Now we look into albums and see what they've done, and this album is the only one that I see there, and it came out in 1980. That is the only album that they have listed. Who are they going to be friends with? Who are the related artists? Now's the time for that. We look at the related artists and see if we recognize any of these. Maybe they're going to be from somewhere else as well, because you've got Tyson Dog. You've got Saracen. That's S-A-R-A-C-E-N. Bitches Sin. That sounds familiar to me. Praying Mantis. Yes, of course. Vardis. Persian Risk. Titan. Jaguar. Witchfind, yes, I've heard of them. Hollow Ground, Blind Fury, and Nightwing. So that is the related artist for this band. Now, there is no image. I mean, there's the album image of the band, but we are going to find an image of the band and place it up. And I'm sure it's going to be them, and they're going to be looking into that camera as if to say, come on, baby, if you want it, come get it. But they do have a bio here, so we're going to get into that right now. One of the many bands associated with the new wave of British heavy metal, White Spirit, is now mostly remembered as the first appearance of guitarist Janick Gers, Iron Maiden. Oh, wow, who later went on to greater fame with the Ian Gillan band and Iron Maiden, formed in 1975 by Gers and drummer Graeme Crallan. White Spirit bided their time as the punk revolution unfolded, eventually completing their lineup with vocalist Bruce Ruff, keyboard player Malcolm Pearson, and bassist Phil Brady, latching on to the fast-rising movement known as the New Wave of British Heavy Metal. The quintet issued their first single, Back to the Grind, in May 1980 through Neat Records, while many of their peers were looking to Black Sabbath, Judas Priest, Motorhead for inspiration. White Spirit organ heavy sound, wow, was heavily influenced by Deep Purple, a rare choice at the time. Believe it or not, picked up by MCA, they released an eponymous album in September, but when it failed to chart, the label lost interest, pulled what small promotion resources they committed to begin with, and the band quickly fell to pieces. So there you have that. So this is the album. They get it on MCA, and then all of a sudden it doesn't do what they want it to do, and all of a sudden that's it. Wow. I wonder which one of these little fellers, if I could pick him out. Janick Gers. Yeah. Wow, that's cool. I always love the idea that Iron Maiden kept him around, right? Was it Adrian Smith that left the band? And when he came back, they said, we'll just keep you, buddy. We love you. I don't know. Put that in the comments below. I might be talking out my ass. It is time to hear Midnight Chaser from White Spirit. If you're ready, here's the magic titty. I give you a taste. I take a taste. We listen together. Here we go. Let's see what this is all about. Oh, yeah. You gotta fire that keyboard up.
Midnight feels right. Step into my
This ain't bad at all. This might be an album to go listen to. Definitely hear the Deep Purple influence. Why wouldn't this be charting, man? 1980? Is that Gers? Is he throwing his guitar all over the studio while he's playing this? Take you on a pleasure cruise. Did you hear that little cowbell there? Got a tight pause. You gotta end it with a stomping on a dime. Are they gonna fade it out? They gonna bring in Harry? This is a high-octane rocker, man. I like this. This is perfectly fine by me. If Gers started this band, he's damn well going to get his solos in there. Starting to feel like they have to go for the fade out. They had it where they could have just stopped on a dime, but now. There's Harry, they brought him here. Keep on rocking, White Spirit. Keep on going, baby. Yeah, you're doing good. Yep, they have to do that. They where they were fired up and firecrackers there on that first song, they could very well have, Red Skies has got a big old organ bit too. When it was all furious and fast fire there, they could have easily They could have easily stopped on it, but they didn't. They kept going, and they threw in that solo, and then, of course, the solo is going to drag forever, so they have to go, how are we getting out of this, guys? And Gers says, I'm not going to quit soloing, bro. So we're going to have to fade this out. So they call in Harry. If you don't know who Harry is, Harry's this one guy in the entire world that all he does is fades out songs. He goes around the world. And a band, they get a hold of him. They say, we've got a song here that we need to fade out at the very end. He flies anywhere in the world. He fades the song out perfectly. They pay him lots of money. And then he goes about his day. That's all I've got for this. So what did you think of that? Good, great, fantastic. Hell yeah, that was some hard rock and stuff. I know this album. Here's my favorite songs. And did you ever see them play live? I would love to hear that story. I wonder if they have a concert on YouTube that I could watch. Or not good, not great. Yeah, I can see why MCA just dropped them and said they're enough. It wasn't for 1980. It wasn't doing what it was supposed to be doing for them big corporate record label bastards. Oh, did I say that? That's all I've got for this. So, if you have a hard rock, a heavy metal special request, you'd like to see it right here on the channel with a thumbs up to you, click that link in the description below. That's all I got for this. White Spirit.